Welcome to the next episode of Racer Profile. I am at ATK Shack, in Claremont, and enjoying some of the gear over here, as you can see. But speaking of racetracks, we are at Aldous Scribanti Race Circuit this week, where they've just resurfaced the track. And I am chatting to Mike Briggs, ex-professional race car driver, and he's giving me some tips around the track. And the car we're in is the brand new 2018 Megane RS Lux. Check it out, Racer Profile starts now.
And yeah. Now you're gonna see if you trust me or if I trust you. We're gonna go. Keep going. Go, 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 go. Break hard. Hard, hard, hard. And come off, turn in, keep it against the
curve.
Keep it against, keep it, and
this is the Renault Megane RS Lux. It has 205 kilowatts, four-wheel steering, and has some incredible technology, including a shock absorber within a shock absorber. It's wider, lower, and has 19-inch wheels. It is very fast around a circuit. How fast? We are about to find out. Welcome to a slightly wet Aldous Scribanti circuit. And I'll be testing out first Renault's launch control in the brand new Megane RS EDC. I'm not sure how this works. I think it's like that. Here we go.
And foot down and go.
Foot down and go. A little bit of torque steer there because it's raining. And then hard on the brakes. Whoopsie. Woo! Can't impress off the line. 5.8 seconds. This is a Golf GTI competitor, and it's way faster than the Golf GTI Noto 100. Oh my god, and that is
Mike Briggs in the second of the Opel Astras. Briggs has been the dominant driver in the Stanek Satcar Series this season, and was a hot favorite to take pole position. Briggs comes from a racing family, and although still in his early 20s, has a wealth of experience behind him. He started out in karts, is a former national champion in the Group N Standard Saloon Car category, and a season or two ago also won the South African Drivers' Championship when he dominated the Formula GTI single-seater category. Mike has also driven sports cars and modified saloons and has taken to sack cars like a duck to water.
So we are on the newly tarred circuit, and it's completely different. This was the old surface.
This is the old surface we're on now. You can hear and see. Okay, we're clear to go. We're good to go. This is change the circuit. I mean, this
completely.
This is probably, for me, it's my hometown. This is my backyard. This is where we developed Superboss. So it's the best circuit in terms of developing a car.
Yeah, whoa. You developed the Superboss here?
Superboss. This, the Superboss was born on this
car. No way!
This is the birthplace of Superboss.
Why are there not more Opels in racing?
You know, it's one of the saddest things. Opel and motor racing built the Opel brand. And we used to have a saying, what wins on Saturday sells on Monday. And Opel built such a strong brand on that. You know, unfortunately, as a brand, they got caught out in this. You know, General Motors didn't have the interest. And, you know, it's just sad because from a South African perspective, Opel has such a strong following because it was seen as the driver's car.
So here we go. Track tips with Mike Briggs.
Here we go. But I'm just going to tell you where the brake markers are and aiming for turning points.
Yes. Okay.
So, and when I say go, 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 you go. And then
just
keep going, keep going. Lift off, turn in, and floor it, floor it, floor it. That's it. See, how much faster is that?
That was nice.
Okay.
That was
now
nice.
Now keep going, keep going.
Okay, we're going to so go past.
That's
you.
It. Go, 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 go. On the brakes. Hard, hard, hard. Come off, turn in, curb. And
curb, yeah.
And now floor it. Flat, flat. Now run wide out there. Riding wide out there.
All the way wide.
Okay. You see.
You know what's
up. Now you're gonna see if you trust me or if I trust you. We're gonna go. Keep going. Go, 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 go. Break hard. Hard, hard, hard. And come off, turn in, keep it against the curve. Keep it against, keep it, and floor it now, Ed. Floor it, that's it. Okay, and go, go, go. Break. Turn in and keep it against this. That's it. Keep it against this curve. Keep it now one. So go, 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 go. Come to the side. Lift off. Turn in and accelerate, flatten, flat out, run wide.
That's I braked it. A little bit of it.
That's fine. Go, 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 go. And brake hard now. This one you're going to really slow down.
that term gets thrown around quite a lot, like a legend of motorsport. You know you're a legend, right?
Well,
don't
I'm
be gonna, shy.
I wouldn't even know how to spell it. Well, it does make an old man feel good. So, yeah. It's motorsport is my life. It's been good to me. It's given me so many opportunities.
And what a good car as well, man. Things like
so that is it for this week's episode of Racer Profile. Join us again next week as we take a closer look at the guys that will be taking part in Drift City next month. See you then.